Welcome to the Cathedral Sacristy again. Today we're going behind the scenes on the vestments that the priest wears and how he vests. You might think he's just putting the outfit on he needs for Mass, right? But there's so much more to it. And this preparation for Mass, the putting on of each of the vestments, actually is something that profoundly sort of prepares me, body and soul, to enter into the sacrifice of the Mass, right? As a priest, I kind of get that, I don't know, it's a nice gift actually to sort of force myself. I have to have 5 or 6 or 7 minutes, you know, to put everything on so that I'm ready to celebrate the Mass. And the first thing is actually a simple one. The first thing the priest is going to do is he's going to wash his hands. Now, there's a prayer associated with this that I usually say in Latin, but I'll sort of explain it to everybody in English. Obviously, you want to make sure your hands are clean. But when the priest prays that prayer, he's asking that the Lord would give virtue to my hands, that he would make my hands sort of that sacred, in order to enter into this sacred sort of sacrifice, this sacred action. My hands were consecrated by chrism when I was ordained, right? So these are something that I want to take care to sort of step back and say, I'm not just typing out an email or, you know, like pulling weeds in the garden. No, I'm about to do something that's sacred, that's beautiful, that's holy, that's of Christ. And I want to sort of set my hands even aside before I do that. There's a funny story actually about the priest that helped build this cathedral, Monsignor Timothy Hickey. It is said that he would go on a walk every single day of the year around the cathedral. You know, he would walk around the block or whatever, and he'd always wear gloves when he was out there. People would be like, in the middle of the summer, like, why are you wearing gloves? But he wore gloves every day because he wanted to remind himself that his hands were kind of meant for holy things, right? And that wearing of gloves was a simple way or a funny way for him to sort of hold that thought in his mind. Anyway, I don't wear gloves all the time, but I do wash my hands before I celebrate Mass. The first vestment is what's called the amice. Oftentimes you'll see a priest that he'll kiss that before he puts it on. But basically, practically, this is, it collects sweat, right? Like, you don't want to have sweat sort of soaking into your nicer vestments. And so this is something that the priest would put on before he puts on anything else. And the prayer that the priest prays when he puts this on is, references the line from St. Paul about the helmet of salvation. He sort of puts it on around his neck, right, around his head. So he's asking the Lord, like, hey, protect me as I'm entering into this sacred time of prayer. It gets tied simply around the back and around the front, like so. The actual prayer that the priest says, we have them listed here. So the first one there, washing his hands, give virtue, O Lord, to my hands. You can see the rest of it. And the second one, the amice, place, O Lord, on my head the helmet of salvation, that I may overcome the assaults of the devil. The fact is that Jesus has won the battle already for us, right? Like, I'm not fighting this on my own, much less with my own strength. And I need to remind myself that. When I'm going into Mass and I'm fighting distraction, or I'm fighting, I don't know, just being grumpy or being tired or being whatever, fighting any of those assaults of the evil one, even those lies or whatever that are trying to get into my mind, I need to ask the Lord's protection on me during this action that is truly His, right? Again, sometimes a priest will kiss these vestments, each of them, as he puts them on. This is the alb. Now, alb in Latin simply is the word for white, and it obviously, references the fact that this is a white outfit. This would have been a pretty typical, just middle-range piece of clothing that people would wear. As you can imagine, Jesus would have worn something along these lines, or a person in Rome during the, you know, second century would have worn something along this, just as his daily garment. So it wasn't particularly set aside at that point, except insofar as it would often be made out of linen or some sort of special material that would indicate that, oh, this is for a sacred purpose. More than that, though, is the color white. White was not an easy color to keep things white in the ancient world. Like, it's easy to keep things gray or beige or tan or whatever, right? Brownish colors. But white is sort of special. You got to work hard to keep things nice and white. And people would have had to work hard to keep the clothing that they wore for Mass white. It symbolizes the purity, the sanctity, the gift of baptism. When we baptize a child, we clothe them in white, right? When a bride gets married, she clothes herself in white. When a priest gets vested for Mass, he clothes himself in white. And when we're buried as a Christian, we place a white cloth over the casket, right, to symbolize our baptism. This is our baptismal purity, our baptismal dignity as a son or a daughter of God. When I put on this alb, I want to remind myself of that. And you'll see servers or cantors sometimes, or other people that are working in some ministry, in some liturgical ministry during the Mass, will sometimes wear an alb. It's a vestment, it's a garment for all baptized Christians because we've all been baptized into the, being washed in the blood of the Lamb, right? Okay. I should say the prayer for the alb goes like this. Purify me, O Lord, from all stain, and cleanse my heart, that washed in the blood of the Lamb, I may enjoy eternal delights. Okay, the cincture. This is, practically speaking, just a belt. This is the tool belt of the priest, I suppose, right? But it also, it holds the garment together, and it symbolizes purity and the chastity with which I should celebrate the Mass. Different priests tie this different ways. This is the knot that I've learned and that I always do. I don't know another knot, but there are different versions of that knot. It doesn't have to be a specific knot, but the idea is that you're gonna end up with it around the waist, holding the alb together, and now you can make two loops with that cincture because the stole is going to go underneath. Again, it's meant to hold everything together. All right, we've got all the different colors of vestments here, but I'll go with gold, which we usually wear on a solemnity. This is the stole. The prayer that's associated with the stole goes like this. Restore to me, O Lord, the state of immortality, which was lost to me by my first parents. And although I'm unworthy to approach your sacred mysteries, grant me nevertheless eternal joy. The stole looks like, sort of like a yoke of some sort, right? It's something that would allow you to carry us a burden, right? To carry a load. Now, it also sort of symbolizes the authority or the leadership of the priest. When the priest is offering the Mass, of course, we're all united together in making our own offering to the Lord, but the priest is leading and sort of guiding his flock in a certain way. And so he puts on this stole as a symbol of the authority of Christ that's given to him. It's not his own authority, right? It's something that's bestowed upon him, given to him by the Lord, and of course he has to live it in that way. But the stole is not the last vestment. The last vestment, it's called the chasuble. It comes from the word casa, right? House, because it's a very, very large kind of baggy vestment. And it goes over the top of everything else. Practically speaking, this is the garment that a shepherd would wear way back in the day. Basically a poncho, right? It works in any weather. You can roll up the sides if you're hot. You can tuck the whole thing over if you're hot, but it also protects you from wind, from rain, from whatever. That's the practical side. Obviously, in the church, it began to be decorated in this beautiful way, beautiful fabric, these different pieces that would, the different colors and the different pieces would symbolize different feasts for the Lord or symbolism to indicate a Christ or Our Lady or the saints or whoever, right? Also, it began to symbolize charity, which charity is something that's put over the top of everything else. And not just love in a run-of-the-mill sense, right? The charity of Christ. This completely covers me as a priest, right? Because I'm no longer acting as myself. When I step out there to celebrate Mass, I'm not really doing it as Dominic Rankin. I'm doing it as Father Dominic Rankin, who's standing in the person of Christ. And so Christ's charity has to clothe me, and very physically, practically speaking, this thing covers me completely, right? There's a certain sort of surrender of myself into who does Christ need me to be as I offer the sacrifice. And the prayer that goes with this one references that yoke, but the yoke that the Lord makes sweet and light. O Lord, who said my yoke is sweet and my burden light, grant that I may carry it so as to obtain your grace. Amen. Usually the priest, right before he celebrates the Mass, is going to say another little prayer in the sacristy before he goes out. There's different variations on the prayer. I usually say something from my heart to the Lord, just asking him to prepare us, prepare me, to celebrate the Mass well. And then I finish with that beautiful prayer from the Divine Mercy Chaplet, which perhaps we can pray together. Eternal Father, I offer you the body and blood, soul and divinity of your dearly beloved Son, our Lord Jesus Christ, in atonement for our sins and those of the whole world. Amen.